So the first thing I'm going to do is just darken up the top window. So I'm going to use the teal and blue, a bit of yellow in it, just for a darker wash, just to come into this window pane, bring the tone up a bit. It's too light at the moment. Get it to sit back into the shadow a bit more. So just knocking down all these lighter spots. And the next thing will be to put some slightly darker colour into the decorated windows. So I'm going to use Payne's Grey and some of the burnt sienna. So it's got a bit of brown in it to warm it up. I'm just going to start to paint in some of these sections a bit darker. Just darken this up a bit more. Do the same on the other side. Some darker spots in. Just darken it up a bit in there. I'm going to put some more water into that same grey brown and add a bit more darkness to this lower section. So this will be lighter than the top section. Just to bring some of the detail out in this doorway. I'll do the same on this side. Just need to put the little holes in. A bit darker. Darken it up all the way around. And then I need to put a bluer wash, some more blue in it, more cerulean, over this top section. I'm just going to dry it up first before I do that. Thank you. put a more blue colour over the actual ironwork to make it less white all the way through, coming down to the shadow, the light area, and in the light area keep it quite light. So I'll do the same on the other side, just knock the whiteness down a bit. And then start to detail up some of the panels in the door. So again, more cerulean grey. So in the doors themselves, we've got some slightly darker bits on the panels. So I'm just going to lay some of that in on dry paper, obviously. Coming down the edge of the window. Same on this one. Do the same on the underside of the this section. Get some of these details in these panels. So we've got a slightly darker top there and down. More water. Underside of this panel. Down. A few detail bits in there. We've got a bit more of a, not shadow, but a darker piece to this panel. More water. Few bits of dark in this panel here. We'll do the same on this panel. The inside edge. Darker in the center here. More blue. just some various patches of blue. Slightly bigger brush now. More cerulean blue. And bring some more variation into this woodwork, where it's meeting the, it meets the plaster. Needs a bit more colour on it. More blue coming down. The bottom and drop in some ochre, slightly stronger now. Down here, just a bit of water in there as well. Do the same on the other side. Some more blue, cerulean blue. So coming down this side of the door. Water. Spread that out a bit. Blue down here. All the way to the bottom. Bit of orange or yellowy orange for variation. A few bits of that here and there. Some more blue now into the panels on the door. Perhaps a bit more turquoise actually. Or the cobalt teal, I should say. So I'll bring some of that in here. So onto dry paper. And that kind of comes up, leaving some little patches of lighter blue show through. Down. Down to the bottom. Same on this side. More blue there. Slightly more cerulean now. Bottom of the door. Work that into some of these little holes and patches, right the way to the bottom. Where it meets the step. And then on this door, I'm going to put some water on it first. So I want this door to be slightly lighter than the other door. Use the bluey purple, bluey colours. I'm going to leave this area up here lighter. Bring it around the door handle. Coming down. Across across the bottom. Again, a bit darker at the bottom. So more cerulean blue. More blue down there. And then I'm going to put some more grey into my step. So I'm just going to wet the step. So the front edge of the step is going to be quite Payne's grey, a bit of brown, and the burnt sienna in it. So all the way through here, make this darker. More shadow. Much more shadow through there. Take that all the way across. Just to tidy up the bottom there. Gonna bring some darker browny greys. Quite strong now. Just to get some strength into the drawing up here. Just going to get the edge of the door frame a bit stronger. So under here it's quite dark. Just darken that up a bit, give it a little spray. Get some more cracks now down in this bottom section. So using the grey brown again with plenty of water in it. So it's very watery. So I'm going to start to develop this as a darker patch of plaster that's coming off the wall. Develop up this a little bit. Bringing that or linking that into the edge of this crack, and then perhaps that crack comes across and then down into the edge of the door frame. Just using the same greys to give some edges to this plaster, some cracks in it. We'll have some of those on this side. Got some wires and different pieces coming down on this left hand side, a bit bluer, a bit too dark, so I make this bluer now. So just cutting in here with some shapes, link that here, loops. Wires, and then we'll have maybe like a bracket or something on the wall there. Some more cracks. blue. Just to get this edge in. More cracks coming down the wall here. Just give those a little spray. Some lighter cracks now in the main body of plaster. So very, very dilute ochre-y greys. Start to bring some patches of slightly darker colour into here. Within the larger plaster area. More on this side. And then I feel like I need a bit of red. I'm just going to take some neat red. Have a couple of spots of red in it. So just on the edge of this shadow, touch more red, the odd bit in here, could maybe have a little bit of red just up in the windows up there, smudge it in a bit. Flick up in the shadow. Maybe there was a bit of a paint spill there at one time. Right, then onto my little electric meter. Just need some of those lighter greys just to work into the body of it. Knock the white down a bit. I'll just get the door handle in now. So I'm going to use the burnt sienna, Payne's grey again, and I'm going to put some yellow ochre in that as well, to make a very dirty brown grey. Just going to get the shape in first. And it comes down, all the way down. And then the handle kind of comes off curved like so. We'll let that dry. Have a few bits of that dirty grey here and there. Maybe there's some nail heads or bolts just poking their head through the paintwork. Bits of darker colour up here in the shadow. variation. Take a bit of orange or yellowy orange, pretty yellow. Just want to run a bit of that on the edge of this shadow, just to heighten the shadow a bit more. Touch more yellow. Soften that in. A bit more of that yellowy orange. Perhaps we'll have some of that on the edge of the door. Just bleed that in. Tiny bit of that on the metalwork for rust. Here and there. And give that a little spray. So just to finish, I'll add a few stronger dark marks. I'm going to take some Payne's Grey with some ultramarine in it, very dry, with my rigger, and use this to get a few drawing marks in. I feel like it needs a bit more strength in the drawing. Payne's Grey. So again, very, very dry brush marks. Not being too neat with it, I just want to get a bit of definition back into the door. Some of these cracks and crevices. So the key to this is to use the paint very dry. Don't let it get too moist to get those nice marks. Just a bit more dark in the doorways. The width there. Get some of these dry drag marks at the bottom. Or the base of the door. A bit on the step. In the base of the door there. Perhaps the odd mark here and there, a few dots, cuts. We've got some wires, perhaps there's a wire hanging down. A bit more realistic, a little bit less neat. A few more bits of something going on there. Slightly more darks in the windows here, slightly drier. Just going to do the same type of mark with my turquoise, just taking it straight out of the tube. So still with the rigger, nice and dry, just to detail up some of this lower section. I'm going to get that too dark when it's still to be quite light, but a bit bluer. So just get these marks coming down. Stronger. Bit more detail around the doors. Stand out a bit more. A bit stronger. I'll tone around the base of that window. There. And then I'm going to use a bit of white. Still using it pretty dry again, just to pick out a few highlights on the base of this window. A few spots here and there. It's a bit lighter in there. Can have a bit of light on this box. Touch more on the lid. Perhaps we've got some more. Perhaps a bit of light there coming down that pole. A few spots. Bits of light here and there. And then I'm just going to do a little bit more sanding. So a clean sandpaper. Lift out a bit more light in here. So this is rubbing back into the gesso. Just to lift out some more of the texture. Some of these paler patches to show up a bit stronger. Have some of that on there. Just got a bit more light on this right hand side. Stress it a bit more. A bit down there. And I think with that, the painting is finished. So if you've enjoyed watching the video, please subscribe. There's an option down the bottom right hand corner of the screen where you can click the subscribe option. And if you like the video, there's others in the playlist, so please browse and have a look, and hope to see you again soon.